Hey, what's up, man?
Oh, whoa. Dude.
I don't know,
what's
man.
Going on?
I just got a haircut, but now I really feel like somebody's just gonna like pop out of nowhere and just take a cut right out of my beard.
Why would anyone do that? That's ridiculous.
I don't know, man. I got a hunch.
Do you hear that?
I hear that. Yep. So today, we're gonna be doing some trivia. Caleb Vorpahl is gonna be the trivia lord, which is convenient because we're doing trivia about Lord of the Rings. Mm. This is just a really cool chess set that I have.
Ugh. Okay. Ugh.
That's cool.
Ugh. Hi, I'm Aaron Mickey Ricky Radke.
Hi, I'm Connor. Neil.
I am Caleb Fetch with Ruff Ruffman Vorpahl.
And this is the Untitled Weekly Show. And this is the Untitled Weekly Show.
Where we say what we want and you tell us how much you like it online.
Is that how that goes?
Not really, but we'll roll with it. So today. So we brought Caleb over here because Connor and I just had a really crazy idea. Let's just do some trivia and then create punishments for ourselves. Connor decided for each question he gets wrong, he's gonna shave a chunk of his beard off.
That is the way.
My punishment will be determined
less severe
at a later date. Yeah. And then we will commit an entire video to my suffering.
Suggest in the comments what kind of physical pain and agony we should inflict on Aaron.
I'm just happy to be here. Big fan of the show.
So the way this is gonna work is Caleb is gonna pull out one of these cards. You're gonna ask a question, and then we're both gonna try and turn on the light that we have. And so it's up to you to determine who turned the light on first. But when somebody gets one wrong, the other person has a chance to steal.
Okay.
All right, so you go ahead and ask the first question.
Who crashes? Did you see the back of the car?
No.
Go ahead.
I thought you were gonna finish reading it.
That's it, I got two words in.
Who crashes? No, you get to hear the rest after I fail this. I'm just gonna go with Boromir, because I think I remember something.
Boromir is incorrect.
Shoot.
I think I get to read the rest of the
read
question.
Read the rest of the question.
Please.
So if you get this right, we can shave off a part of his beard. Who crashes into Frodo in Farmer Maggot's
Field? Oh, come on, that's such an easy question.
I don't even know it.
That's Merry, right?
The correct answer is
Pippin!
I had a 50-50 shot.
You did have a 50-50 shot. Survived one round. Okay, I'm gonna wait for the question this time.
Okay, who does Frodo teasingly accuse of being late for Bilbo's birthday party? I think Connor was first.
I think it's Gandalf.
Gandalf is correct, yeah. So one.
That's a punishment point.
One punishment point.
For Aaron.
For Aaron. What rises from Sauron's helmet after it falls to the ground in an epic battle of the Second Age? It's really easy.
I think, is it just smoke?
Smoke is correct, Aaron?
It couldn't have been that, what? I'm like thinking about like, oh, what metaphor am I thinking of? What Tolkien mannerism am I missing? It's
smoke.
Okay.
I'm gonna die.
What apparition does Gandalf see when he reaches for the ring at Bag End? Aaron.
He sees the eye.
That is correct.
Yeah, all right.
Okay, how do we want to do this?
No, first you got to go straight down the middle.
Straight down the middle. All right.
Straight down.
Well, I think I have to go straight up the middle. All right, here we go. Oh, gosh. Oh, Lord.
Oh, my Lord.
Aaron's punishment is that he's got to put a mouthful of this in his...
Yeah, one mouthful per question. Okay.
What emotion, according to the orc leader, Goth Mog, is Minas Tirith rank with?
Okay.
We're going to have to do an instant replay. Post, instant replay, go. Due to the fact that I totally just reviewed that footage, I'm going with Aaron.
Fear.
It is.
Yeah, I went with Aaron because I want to shave some more. All right, here we go. Oh my god.
Oh, that is a chunk. Look at that right there. All right, do one of the real hard ones.
Wait, you want to do one of the bottom ones? Those are not even about the actual movie.
I know.
That's about the people who made the movie.
I know.
Do you understand? That's not even...
We're testing our mettle as filmmakers. Just do it.
What character was recast because, according to Peter Jackson, he had been cast too young the first time?
I'm just going to throw this out there. Aragorn.
Oh, my Lanta. Oh, wait, I can't shave you.
That is incredible. This goes until that man's chin is visible.
All right.
With the vacuum. Ooh.
What race, according to Saruman, will drive the machine of war?
The Uruk-hai.
Is that your final answer?
That's the first thing popped in my head.
The problem with this is that I have the power to figure out how specific you're supposed to be. And so I think I'm going to go with that is it incorrect.
That's not specific enough?
And that is not specific. Well, I'll even give it a hint to Aaron because I'm really in the mood to shave. It was too specific.
It's just orcs.
Just orcs?
There it is. Oh my goodness.
There we go. That ain't good, is it?
I love it how it's all on the left side because that's like in my blast radius. Like your other side's untouched. Your other side's
I will reserve judgment until it's finished.
Who does Galadriel give the light Elinthriel?
Oh, he got me.
Frodo.
That is correct.
Yep. Oh, word.
That's the right side, my dude.
I mean, the other side of what we've already shaved.
Oof.
Let me look at
Hold
you
on,
now.
Just...
Oh my, there is a problem. You look like one of them squirrels who caught something.
Connor is the physical embodiment of a squirrel.
Who caught something?
Yes, Connor is a squirrel with mange.
Who does Frodo threaten with his sword at Osgiliath.
My answer is the person he threatens with a sword. I'm pretty sure is Sam.
That is correct. That is another mark for another
episode.
Another man
episode. Okay, where does Legolas wear his knives on his back or in his or on his belt or strapped to his ankles?
It's on his back.
That is correct.
At first I thought you were like, that's a lot of plates. I was like he doesn't wear them all there, but then it was a list.
It's a big 5-0, buddy.
Yeah, buddy. Big 5-0.
What is Aragorn cleaning when Eowyn offers him stew?
He's cleaning his sword, right?
That would make sense, and that is correct.
All right, hand's staying on the string.
Who misunderstands Aragorn's declaration that he will not be coming back as an underestimation of his skill in battle?
I'm not gonna lie, I just pulled the light, just like, just like.
King of Rohan.
That is incorrect. That is correct.
Because Eowyn thinks he's gonna die, and then he kind of almost
building a
does.
Tower over here. What is the orc battering ram at Helm's Deep primarily made of metal, stone, or wood?
Oh, I was gonna say the name of it.
Oh.
Gorg.
Actually, it was not metal, but
what? Is it wood?
I was just in the moment. I had to.
Aaron gets the answer then.
What? Wood?
Yes.
What?
Gorg. Alrighty, next question. Who says he was once known as the Grey Pilgrim? That was definitely Connor.
Gandalf.
Gandalf is correct. You're up to 9.
I've been sweating this whole time too.
Me too.
What type of skeletons surround Gollum in his cavern hideout?
I clicked it, but I don't even know. Skeletons? It's a goblin skeleton.
Dub. What? This is the one thing that I knew right away.
It might have been orc, but.
Nope. Orc! you better play an image of an orc skeleton of the movie right now. Otherwise, what do I get?
You're gonna have to eat this.
Wait, I'm right, you're wrong. Dude, what was Gollum most known for?
Fish.
So?
There you go.
Fish skeleton.
Thank you! Skeletons. I feel like that was part of the movie where he goes, freedom! What H word does Treebeard call Mary after he complains that the Ents...
A halfling.
That is incorrect.
Oh!
Wait, yeah,
finish
right.
The question.
Complains that the Ents are taking too long.
Oh, it's shoot, literally. It's like one of my favorite lines in the whole movie.
It's literally in the question.
Don't be hasty.
That is correct.
I was trying to get it too.
You gotta keep turning. Keep turning.
Okay, we're gonna go along the chin line here.
Don't be hasty. But he didn't call him hasty. He told him not to be hasty. He called him a halfling.
See, Connor, this is why you shouldn't be hasty.
This is not pleasant at all.
How is it not pleasant?
I thought it would be a lot more fun than this.
I look at Connor and I just see the little, like, thin mustache that is now left. And all I hear is, vote for Pedro.
We're going with the hardest questions. What creature's horse breath was achieved by blending the recorded sounds of a tiger and a lynx?
It's the troll.
Oh my. What kind of troll?
Cave troll. Baby
yes.
Cave troll.
I can't believe it.
I picked up the wrong card and I was like, Orlando Bloom?
Orlando Bloom?
That's how he got his heavy breathing?
Who tells Frodo about the origin of the Nazgul?
That would be Aragorn.
Okay. Who stops Grima from escaping the Golden Hall?
That would be Aragorn.
That is incorrect. Give me your face. It is Gimli.
Oh yeah, you're right. It's Gimli. And then Aragorn grabs him and says, totally "Enough blood has been shed this day."
Okay, so how do you want to do the rest of this? I kind of want to do like a my privileges are gone. All right, let me try one more time. Oh.
Now, Connor, get. Look. Connor has taken.
It's getting itchy.
It's getting itchy.
Oh, you're getting rid of
it. Man, he's the Connor I know and love again.
All right, I can see it. You lost about 5 years.
That's true.
You lost about 5 years.
Shouldn't have got the haircut too.
Look at us again.
Oh, put the rest of that on your hair. No, Connor, please.
It's a great thumbnail. It's a great thumbnail.
I'll cease and desist.
Right. I think that's what we got for today.
Thank you for coming to the first and hopefully last Untitled Weekly Show quiz night. Tune in next week where
I try to glue this back.
we try. Why don't we? Do we have glue?
No. I'm out.
Thanks for having me.
I'm done.
Well done.
Show's over. Show's over.